It's been long since the last time I did a video, and today I just wanted to show you. I did a blueberry compote and a passion fruit compote, and I wanted to show you the outcome. And by the way, there's an upcoming class in the last week of February, date 21st, and then it will be a Monday 21st, Tuesday 22nd, Wednesday 23rd, and Thursday 24th from 9 to 4:30 for the 4 days. There's gonna be intense learning, okay? So I wanted to show you one of the training highlights in that flyer or in the class, upcoming class. One of the training highlights will be showing how to do or to prepare or to cook certain different fruit fillings for your cakes, for topping on your ice creams or for yogurt. And so I want to show you what I did, and it was yesterday, and I chilled it in the freezer, and now it's good to go. So I want to show you, come with me. So by the way, we are doing gelato ice cream. That's Italian ice cream, and in particular, ours in particular has no eggs. So for those who don't want to hear anything to do with eggs in your intake, then this is yours. It's eggless gelato ice cream, or gelato or Italian eggless ice cream. Eggless Italian ice cream. Yeah, so that's it. It's coming in all manner of flavors. All right, so here we have yogurt. It's organic yogurt. Can you put organic in capital letters? Yes. It's organic yogurt. It means it has the probiotics, the good bacteria for your body that helps with your digestion, your ease of bowel movement, and many other functions in your body. And for us, we don't add any preservatives, we don't add any additives. It's purely like raw organic. Good stuff. Creamy, glossy, thick, flowing consistently. It's really yummy. Really yummy. Even actually, there's a client who gave me a feedback. Or she's a lactose intolerant, and she took our organic yogurt, and can you believe it? She was okay. She was like super duper okay. And you see, the thing is, if you understand the science behind probiotic yogurt, then you will understand why someone who is lactose intolerant would be able to take this and be okay. It's because the life culture in the probiotic of yogurt helps to break down the lactose in the milk, the sugars in the milk. So that's why it is, you know, good for even the lactose intolerant. All right. So this is the organic yogurt. These ones, normally I put them chilled. I keep them chilled. These are Chamdo, white and red, and please come see, they're alcohol free. I only deal with alcohol free drinks. So this is white Chamdo, this is red Chamdo. So I normally keep them chilled so that whenever the client wants them, or maybe during Valentine's, sometimes I'm asked to deliver a bouquet, a cake plus a bouquet of flowers and chocolates and chamdo, either red or white. So I like keeping them chilled because they are tastier when chilled. All right, so here we go to the compote. All right, so we have the blueberry. I have done several, so I'll just remove one. And the passion. What else? I also wanted to show you our caramel. So maybe you could come with me and see as I remove the caramel. So there's this big one here, and there's the others right behind there. Let me just use this. So that's it. So I wanted to show you the compote. And so before I go to the caramel, I will show you this. So now for the passion fruit, I actually prepared using the real fruit with the seeds. But I found out that most clients do not appreciate, or they do not prefer biting into a very soft, tender, moist, yummy cake, and then they are coming across these seeds into their teeth. They don't like it. So That is why after I prepared the compote, then I went ahead and sieved the mixture to remove the seeds. Okay, so here it is. It's pretty liquidy for now. Here it is. Very raw. If you look at it, you can see there's still stuff from the passion fruit, like the fiber from the passion fruit lining, the fruit itself. So it's really, really rich. So this is it. And I actually want to put in, let me mention this before I even go here. I want to say that in the upcoming training, I'm going to be demonstrating how to prepare perfectly the powdered whipping cream or whipped cream. It's perfect. Can you imagine? You can freeze the cream, it thaws, you just, you know, whisk a little quickly and it's back to smooth texture. You know, it's just the answer for all of you bakers. You need to enroll to that class. So you enroll for that class. So I want to put a little passion here in this cream. I don't want to put a lot because it's really intense and the cream is not that much. So I don't know where I'm going to put this. Maybe let me just put here. So this is, so you can do this, you can have your passion compote and include it in your cream as you whip. It's going to be very, very yummy. Alternatively, after you have layered your cake, like after every filling with the cream, you can scoop some of your passion and pour right at the middle and then put another layer of cream, a very thin one, to just you know, press down into it, into the passion, so that it doesn't ooze out. You can also do a wall of cream or buttercream, depending on what you're using for your cake, so that you do a wall to prevent the compote from, you know, oozing out. So yeah, this is it. Let me just oh my god, we are going to demonstrate this in class and guys will be like, wow, 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 where have you been for all this time? Yeah, so I am here. So this is awesome. And I will take it back to the freezer and let it continue chilling and holding itself together and all that. So this is blueberry. Let's see. Blueberry is quite heavy and it's awesome. This is what I like. See, look at that. Look at that. So, so, so rich. Very, very rich. Yeah, so here it looks like this. So look at that. Look at that, so beautiful and rich and so these fruits you see, this is real fruits. So we cooked this from scratch and you know, we chilled it and here it is. So you just scoop, again, as I had said, you can use this in your fillings after you know, trying to swallow the saliva from the yumminess of what I've tasted back there with the passion and cream combination. Yeah, so as I was saying, so after you do your filling, again, you can scoop your blueberry compote and pour it right at the middle of that filling, and then spread just a little bit, and then just put a dollop of cream just on top of it, smoothen it gently, and then now place your next layer. So when guys catch on the cake, they find the layers of cream and there's just a compote, the blueberry at the middle, and then maybe you just do the drizzle with the sauces, the caramel sauce, the chocolate sauces. I mean, you guys, you can do a lot of things with your cakes and you can just take them to the next level. And don't allow a vanilla cake to just be a basic cake. This is the time, this is the year you take even your most vanilla, I mean your most basic cakes to the next level. Let people cut into your cake and they're wondering, wait a minute, what did I just eat? What did I just bite into? Let them be lost in their own world because of how yummy your cake is. And you can just improve that taste using the fillings. And I'm going to be teaching that in the next class. So stay tuned. So I'm going to scoop a little. In this case, I'm just going to combine this with this cream here. Just a little because it's really rich. So imagine this is what we also use for the ice creams. And for the yogurt, if you want blueberry, we can do this, but at an extra cost because this one is really pricey. It's a bit pricey to prepare, and also just gathering enough fruits for this. It's not, you know, the prices are a bit on the other side. So, but anyway, it's an option that's available. So this is what I'm talking about. Your blueberry cream with real blueberries. Let me bite into this. Oh my god, you guys, if you have not tasted like a real fruit compote, please do that. Include it in your fillings, drizzle over your ice cream, like you prepare this ice cream from scratch, and also the yogurt. Just do something, put it on your in your smoothie. Even when you're blending your smoothie, just scoop a good amount of this and pour it in your blender, let it blend. Oh my god. Anyway, did I say I was tasting? Because I'm just going to just, you know. Moving on. So, you've seen that. So, I wanted to show you the compote and the consistency. And, oh no, I wanted to do that here. Alright. So, it's okay. Alright, so, back to the chiller, into the fridge, and now I want to demonstrate, to just show you our caramel. Okay. Alright, so this is how I cover the caramel with cling film. It's called the clear wrap in other countries. So yeah, this cling film. I think I don't want to open everything, but I'll just go ahead and open here, and I'll close it up again later. All right. So let me see the outcome of this. Okay. So let me just I want to show you how it looks. From the inside, just to ensure you don't touch it. I won't open a lot, but a greater part. Let me get another spoon maybe to just scoop in. So look at that. This is our caramel. Look at that. So thick and yummy. Let me tell you guys, if you know how to prepare caramel, you know it's not an easy feat. You know it's not just a walk in the park. This thing can really let you down, and you have to start from scratch. But yeah, so here's the caramel. Look at that, so beautiful. So we are selling these too. We are selling this too. You have to order in advance so that we prepare. Like this one is someone's order. So yeah, you have to order yours in advance. Oh, sorry. So I am going to now just pour a little on this cream. Okay, a little, just a little. It's really intense. Don't put a lot, it's really intense. So. Okay. Oh, maybe I should just use this. So here's the caramel. And you can drizzle it on your ice cream, on your yogurt. It's really super yummy. Super yummy. So as usual, I'm gonna have a taste on your behalf.
Okay, guys. Just try your caramel, do it, and put it in your cream. And you tell me what you think. Give me your feedback in the comment section below. This is funny because, you know, I've been taking smoothie for the whole week and I'm here eating, partaking of cream with caramel, blueberry, passion. It's so yummy. It's irresistible. Sometimes you just need to treat yourself to something nice and, you know, sometimes hard times in life and sometimes you just want to sit down and just spoil yourself. Alright, so that's it. I'm gonna cover these shortly after the video. So I'm gonna keep these aside and just so now the next thing I want to show you is our very fast gluten-free block cake. Alright, so here. So here, let me actually just change these. And so we have our lemon gluten-free cake. I want you to see how it looks like. Maybe I should have just taken two blocks, but I'll just have to work with these. Look at this, so beautiful. Good. Alright, let me put these aside. Alright, so tender, you have to be really careful. Alright, so here it is. So this is our gluten-free cake and I want to cut into the cake so that we can see. Alright, so let's first see the, let me just cut. Look at that. So soft. Oh my. Look at that. Look at that consistency. That texture, that crumb is so beautiful. Very beautiful. This is so yummy. And I just want to show you how it looks like. And it's really yummy. Very low in sugar. It's gluten-free, so for you who, for everyone who knows much more about gluten-free cakes, gluten-free ingredients, you know this is the real deal. So yeah, we have these cakes now, and for all those that have been asking, you know, when I will start doing gluten-free cakes, now this is the time. You know, this at the right time, God makes all things beautiful, and I believe He has made this time beautiful for us to even start doing gluten-free cakes. The organic yogurt, and so that you know, so many people will be blessed by these products. So now we are doing this, so don't be left behind. Please go ahead and make your order. And of course, I'm gonna have to bite into this one on these cakes using these creams. And I don't know if I should have you watch, or I don't know if I am making you feel something. Like, am I making you feel kiwaru? Am I Felicia-ing you? So I just want to taste. Oh my god. Maybe I should just taste with blueberry. So yeah. It's so yummy. It's so yummy, guys. So yummy. So yummy and moist, and it has a very tender crumb. I don't know if you've seen that. It has a very tender crumb. And it's very yummy. It's very low in sugar. Look at that. Look at that. So beautiful. So beautiful. So yeah, so go ahead. I will be making more flavors, but this is just one of them. So go ahead and make your order, and I hope I will get to do this class of gluten-free cakes very soon. So stay tuned, keep watching our videos, and I want to say thank you for all those feedbacks I've been getting about our videos on YouTube channel, that they've been beneficial, they've changed your baking journey, and your cake decorating journey, and just your view about baking and cake decorating and many other things in life in regards and connection to your, to the works of your hands. So thank you for the feedback. I really appreciate it. And I hope I will keep, by the grace of God, posting videos that are beneficial, informative, life-changing, and you stay with me, all right? So remember to leave a comment in the section below. For all of you that I had told me that you've missed my videos, now you better comment. I need to know if you see watched this video. So write a comment, post a comment in the section below. For those who are it's their first time in our channel, Karibuni. Karibuni. You are welcome. Karibuni sana to Tahila Cakes and Caterers. And it's fun to be here. Life is fun. It's how you make it. So please remember to subscribe and turn on the notification button so that every time I post a video, you get notified immediately. Thank you so much. I think that's all for now. If I get another update or if I get time to do another video, I will definitely do one and post it for you guys to watch. Thank you and stay tuned. God bless you.